The medal contenders yet to skate. Here are the standings right now. I'm Vern Lundquist along with Scott Hamilton. Scott, we know a bit about the judging in the sport of figure skating. Nine judges, they score on a 6.0 basis, that being perfect. But there's another element to this called placement.
Wish me luck, Vern. This is very difficult to explain. All the marks that you hear about and you see all add up to a total. As you can see, 5.8, 5.9 add up to 11.7. That is the best point total that judge gave out. So it's a first place ordinal, first place placement. If you look at the next page, you can compare Bechki Petrov's ordinal sheet or placement sheet with Brasseur and Eisler's. As you look down, 11.4 total on the first judge, 11.2, second, third place placement. Go down towards the end and you'll see there's more of a disparity with the judges. The seventh and eighth judge put Bechki Petrov second, Brasseur and Eisler fifth. They take the best average placements, and that's how you come up with your final placement, and boy, is that difficult to explain.
But I can promise you I understand more now than I did 20 seconds ago. Well, the medal contenders are getting ready to perform here in Albertville. Let's go down right now to Tracy Wilson.
As we've seen tonight, there's a lot of attention being focused on the women and whether or not they'll complete their difficult elements. Of the top three women, there's three very different personalities. Isabelle Brasseur is excited. She's so happy to be at the Olympics, she can't wait to skate. Sometimes her excitement gets in the way of the performance. Elena Bechki, she's anxious. She wants to win so badly, she tries too hard and can't relax. Natalia Miskuchonok, she is focused. And usually she skates much better in the competition than she does in the practice. The women will be trying to find that fine line tonight. They want to be strong on the outside, yet remain calm on the inside. When we return, the top four pairs skate for Olympic gold.
Hopes of an entire country ride with this next pair. They represent Czechoslovakia. They are fourth entering the free skate. 16-year-old Radka Kovarikova and her 28-year-old partner, Rene Novotny.
And they are so enjoyable to watch. The opening of their program, crucial side-by-side triple toe loops. Nicely done. She did the triple toe on her own, and now she's going to be thrown into one. Nicely landed on one foot. The openings of these programs are very difficult. Split triple twist, beautiful air position. And the final release move in this opening section, throw triple salchow, two-footed. The real strength of this team, and the next three teams you'll see, is the quality of the overall performance. Radka has probably the best posture of all of the women in the pair event. He struggled that double axel right there. Breaking the program here will cost them on the second mark.
Often the skaters will talk to each other during a performance and say either do the jump or do a single, and it looks like they got their communication crossed. They both hesitated going into the jumps.
Mentioned the hopes of an entire country riding with Kovarikova and Novotny. They're in a battle for a medal, and no Czech team in pairs has ever stood on the podium at the Olympic Games. Again, nine judges, 4.5 minutes on the ice, and the scores in the free program 2/3 of the final result.
And their choreographer don't always agree on which direction to take, but when you combine great artistry and beautiful technical ability, you get a result like this.
The only element missing has been speed. They just don't quite have the dynamic skating style as the top skaters do.
She's the 16-year-old daughter of a bus driver in Brno, Czechoslovakia. He's a geography student. His dad's an economist. And they have just completed their free program.
Here's another look at their throw triple toe at the beginning of the program. He'll assist her into the air, and then she's on her own. Three revolutions, nicely landed on one foot. They struggled a little bit with this. She came off her heel a little bit. No way you can rotate the jump. As Tracy said, they might have crossed signals on the way into it. The pairs do talk to each other. And when things like that happen, a break in the program, it always shows up in the second or the artistic mark.
Now the marks for Kovarikova and Novotny.
And these are great technical marks. What they do very well. Her posture in the air and the lifts, the throws, the way they present themselves, side by side, triple toe loops. They do so many things, and they do it with such great presentation. I would imagine the second mark would probably go up.
Ivan Rezek, their coach.
And you can see from the Czechoslovakian coach of 5'8", these two will only get better.
The Italian judge, the one judge among the nine who did not put them into first place currently.
Well, that 5'3", I think, comes from the break in the program after the missed double axels. But all in all, it's a very strong free program.
The gold medal favorites in Albertville, Natalia Mishkyuchonok and Artur Dmitriev. They skate for the unified team. They now skate for a country without a flag. Earlier this afternoon, Katarina Vitt had some thoughts on what that